Hey, what's going on everybody? It's Joseph from Screenbite, and today I'm going to be showing you an SD card that will allow you to record 400 megabits per second All-I on your Panasonic GH5 for under $100. But before we get into that, you might notice that things look a little bit different in here. That's because I'm trying out some new stuff and I'm building a studio in my house to get a different look. I would really appreciate if you let me know what you think in the comment section down below, because I'm always looking to grow and make things better. But back to the program. So, the Panasonic GH5 has the ability to record 400 megabits All-I after the version 2.0 update. Now this is fantastic because that allows you to record an all-intra codec, which means it's going to be a lot easier on your PC, and theoretically you're supposed to get a little bit better quality out of your camera, which is great. Who doesn't want better quality? The problem with that is if you want to record at that speed, you're going to need a pretty hefty SD card. Now, the SD cards that can do this are classification V60 and above, which means it needs to have a minimum write speed of 60 megabytes per second in order for to record continuously without it cutting out. Which is why if you put in a lot of SD cards into this and try to record at that codec, you can get 10 to 20 seconds, but then it'll cut out because it falls below that threshold. Now, the problem with this is if you want a card that can write that fast, you're going to be putting out a pretty penny. For example, some of the cards out there, an example here would be the SanDisk 300 megabytes per second V90 card, is $300 for 128 gigabytes. I don't know about you, but I don't have $300 just to be throwing around at SD cards. It'd be nice if I could, but I can't. So, me being me and wanting to be cheap, I went to Amazon and tried to look for some solutions. And honestly, there wasn't a lot out there for under 200 bucks. There's also not a lot of V60 cards, which I find pretty strange. There's a couple V60 cards out there, but they're still over $100. And from what I've heard, a lot of them seem to be having issues with this camera. But then I came across this one. This is the Freetail Evolve 128GB card, and I picked it up for $85. Now, when I saw that, I was like, there's no way this card's going to work, but I thought I'd say screw it, give it a try, and at least I can make a video for you guys if it worked, right? And the good news is it does. So I've actually been recording this video on the card in that codec, and as you can see, I'm not having an issue at all. No cutouts, anything like that. You might see some jump cuts, but that's just me editing out all the mistakes. So I would honestly really recommend maybe taking a look at this card, because if you're like me and you're trying to save a few bucks and you just can't afford that much for an SD card, but you want to have the capabilities or the full capabilities of your camera, it's definitely worth a look. I'll leave a link in the description down below if you guys want to check it out or purchase it. It is an affiliate link, so I wanted to let you guys know that, but that helps me grow the channel and helps me out as a person, so I really would appreciate it. But that's gonna go ahead and do it for this video, guys, so thank you once again for watching. As always, if you liked it, make sure to show it by hitting that like button down below. It really helps me out. As well as if you have any questions about what we talked about today, feel free to ask it in the comment section. You could also ask those questions at me on Twitter at Screenbite. Also, if you're new to the channel and you like the content that I make, feel free to subscribe. But until next time, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.